Okay, so we saw how the power series solution works out with a concrete example of the Schrodinger equation, you know, problem for the harmonic oscillator potential. So there we did not worry too much about, you know, convergence issues and things like that. So it was one of those problems where it all works out well. And in fact, we found that the solution that we obtained, you know, based on you know, physical conditions and all, the final solution was in fact a polynomial, so which would be you know, convergent everywhere, right? So, but in general, if you're going to come up with a power series, you know, questions of convergence become important. So, but so in this lecture, we'll only sort of touch upon, you know, this aspect and, you know, talk about how if you have something called an ordinary point about which you're writing a power series solution, there is a theorem which guarantees that it's going to be a convergent series within some region of convergence, right? So we will only barely touch upon this topic in this lecture. Okay, so we are interested in, you know, looking for power series solutions when you have a differential equation of this specific form, right? So it's a homogeneous differential equation and it's non-trivial. What appears on the left hand side is not trivial, and we are focusing on second order differential equations because lots of you know, physics problems are second order in nature, right? So some of these ideas can be extended to higher orders as well, but anyway, so let's look at the second order differential equation. So a standard form to bring this in is, you know, to divide throughout by a naught, right? So we look at a, you know, a revised form of the same differential equation, which is d squared y by dx squared plus p1 of x dy by dx plus p2 of x times y is equal to 0, right? So you may like to make the coefficient corresponding to the highest derivative, which is the second order derivative in this case, to be 1, right? So p1 is a1 of x divided by a0 of x, and p2 is a2 of x divided by a0 of x. Right, so there can be trouble if a naught of x, you know, goes to 0 at some point, right? And, you know, it's not always going to be trouble, right? If there is a, you know, suitable term in a1 or a2 which cancels with this, then perhaps there is no issue. But anyway, so in general, one has to be careful when you're dividing by a function of this kind. And so here is a you know, classification of the type of points about which you can do a power series solution, right? So when we did the problem for the harmonic oscillator problem, it was natural to just write down a power series expansion about the origin. But in general, actually, you can come up with a power series solution about some point x naught, right? So power series solution about a point x naught. It does not have to be the origin. Now, so there is a classification of, you know, points about which you're doing a power series expansion, right? A point x naught is said to be an ordinary point if both these functions p1 of x and p2 of x are analytic at that point, which means that there's no singularity there. So nothing, you know, awkward is happening with respect to a naught. So if a naught is a zero and which doesn't cancel with a zero of a1 or a2, and if either of these has a singularity, either p1 or p2 has a singularity at that point, then it's a problem. Then it's not an ordinary point. It's called a singular point. So there is this theorem which says that if you are doing an expansion about an ordinary point, then you're guaranteed to have, you know, two non-trivial linearly independent power series solutions of this form, right? So, you know, the kind which we saw for the Schrodinger equation, right? So y of x is equal to this, and this is going to be convergent in some region of convergence, mod of x minus x naught less than r. It's a region of convergence around x naught where this is going to be convergent. So this is guaranteed by a theorem which we will not, the details of which we will definitely not be able to go into, but the fact that it exists is useful for us, right? So we can go ahead and crank up the machinery. So we are interested in, you know, some assurance that it would work, and then we want to be able to you know, actually use the method. So quickly, let's look at a few examples of, you know, this classification of these points. So let's look at example one. So if you have this considered, if you consider a differential equation like this, d squared y by dx squared plus x squared dy by dx plus x plus 1 times y equal to 0. So this corresponds to p1 of x is equal to x squared, because there is already 1 sitting, you know, it's the coefficient of d squared y by dx squared. So p2 of x is just x plus 1. So both of which are analytic at all points. So since they are polynomials, so there is no problem at all. So in fact, all points are ordinary points as far as this differential equation is concerned. So you should be able to write down a power series expansion about any point. You don't have to do it about the origin, you can do it about any point, right? So that's very convenient. Let's look at another example where it's not so trivial, if you wish. So suppose you have a differential equation like this. You have x minus 1 d squared y by dx squared plus x squared times dy by dx plus x plus 1 divided by x times y equal to 0, right? So I mean, it's similar to the first differential equation, but I have x minus 1 as the coefficient for the first term here, and I have also this division by x in the last term here. So if I want to bring it to the standard form, then I must divide throughout by x minus 1. So I will get p1 of x is equal to x squared divided by x minus 1, and p2 of x is going to become x plus 1 time divided by x times x minus 1. So what we see is that this first function p1 of x has a non-analyticity or a singularity at the point x equal to 1. So at this point, I think we intuitively see what a singularity means, right? So yeah, you know, when we discuss complex analysis in the next part of this course, we will talk about, you know, these ideas, you know, a little more in depth. So but intuitively we see what singularity here means. So if x equal to 1, you know, there is a singularity as far as p1 of x is concerned. P2 of x has non-analyticity or singularity at two points. One is at x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. So as far as the differential equation is concerned, both the points x equal to 0 and x equal to 1 are singular points. They are not regular points. So the key idea is that, you know, if even one of these two functions, p1 or p2, has a singularity, it's not a regular point. It's not an ordinary point. It's not an ordinary point, right? So it's a singular point. So every other point is an ordinary point with respect to the given differential equation, and you'll be able to use this theorem and, you know, write down a power series expansion about that point, except x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. So although we observe that the point x equal to 0 is a singularity only for p2 of x, p1 of x is not singular here, and yet as far as the differential equation is concerned, x equal to 0 is also a singular point, it's not an ordinary point. So we will look at how the power series solution would work out for an ordinary point, and also we will see that when there are certain very special kinds of singularities will still allow us to write, you know, power series solutions, but that's coming up later. In this lecture, we just wanted to quickly point out what an ordinary point is. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.